Hi, and welcome. I'm Daniel from GMS Instruments, and today I'll be showing you guys what a temperature calibrator is. So this example we have here today is a temperature calibrator by Sika, which is used to calibrate temperature equipment, of course. So to show you this, I have this example thermometer by Tuvo Instruments, which we'll calibrate a bit later on. Then this example temperature calibrator, when you order it, it comes, of course, with a power cable, it comes with a standard sleeve and a sleeve extraction tool. And then because it's calibrated, it also comes with a calibration certificate. So let me first tell you about the sleeve. This is what goes into the temperature calibrator so that the thermometer you're testing will fit better into the device. So these holes here are fit to the inserts of the thermometer. So for example, this one fits very nicely into this one, which means that the temperature gets transferred better to the thermometer. So let me show you how it works. When you're connecting this to the power, you should always first put in the sleeve, because you don't want to do that when it's getting hot. So you simply drop the sleeve into the device, and then you can put the thermometer into the right hole in the sleeve. Then after that, you can put in the power, and then you can turn it on. So when we turn it on, what the device is going to do, it's of course going to heat up. Then first it goes through its startup procedure, and after the startup procedure, it will show you on the bottom the temperature that it's set to, and on the top the temperature that it's currently at. So what you want to do to test your equipment is put the setting to three to five different temperature settings and test the device on each of those settings. So for this device we have a range of 0 to 120 degrees Celsius, so it might be smart to test 20, 40, 60, 80 and 100 degrees Celsius. And what you're going to do is, once the device reaches the temperature that it's set to, you can check whether the device measures the same temperature as the calibrator and write that down. Then you write that down for all of the measurement points and calculate the differences in a percentage, and that will be your accuracy. And then you match the accuracy that you've measured to the accuracy of the device and check if it matches. If it doesn't, you need to have it calibrated. When you're done testing, you turn the device off. And then you should always let it cool down, of course, because especially if you're going to test higher temperatures, maybe 500-600 degrees Celsius, it's going to be hot and you should not get near it. So let it cool down for around 6 hours, and then after those 6 hours, you can take out your device and you can unplug it again, and then you're done. So this was our short introduction on a temperature calibrator. Let me know if you have any questions or if you would like to know more about this product, and thank you for watching.